I have a weird thing with comedy. I love comedy. I love stand-ups. But I just feel like a lot of the time I'm not like in this super laughy, chuckly mood anymore. Don't know why. Like, stuff doesn't crack me up as much anymore. Now, Dave Chappelle is someone who's had me in stitches many, many times. And I was really looking forward to it. And it was kind of mediocre for me. It was kind of like, it was all right. It was good. I enjoyed it, but I didn't really get like stitched up by it. And sometimes I wonder, is that me? Am I just like, am I not in the right mood for this? Because I'm pretty sure on a different occasion I would be. I think it's best to watch stuff like that with your mates, actually. Because the funniest people are always your mates, right? But anyway, I watched it and I found bits of it to be really quite funny and other bits not so much. It's called Sticks and Stones. And I think the idea is like sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me. I don't agree with that. I don't think that's a good fable. I think it is for some people. I think for some people that's all they need to hear. Yeah, words don't hurt me, I'm fine. But everyone in the world has at some point in their life probably been hurt by someone else's words. Words can hurt you. Not physically, okay? You know, unless they say hit the switch and then bam, something breaks your arm. words can hurt you, and I think it's important. I think, you know, the nuanced discussion always seems to be the more valuable one to me. You should keep it in mind that you might be the sort of person who's susceptible to other people's words, but I don't think you being hurt by someone's words means you have the right to cancel them or to take them off air. And I think his whole comedy was basically baiting that. He was really baiting the whole idea of like, hey, you're going to get outraged by this. And that kind of meta way of approaching it was kind of funny. But for me, like, it wasn't the most hysterical thing I've seen. I really enjoyed it. It was good fun. I did feel like his LBG... Oh, God, I'm going to get it wrong. LBGTQ bit was, like, a bit off. I don't think anything should be off limits in comedy, but I think what makes comedy work is when there's some truth in it, when there's something underneath it that's like, it tells you something, it gives you something. And I think when he went into that territory for the content of his jokes, it didn't really feel like he had a point to make at all. It just felt like, hey, here's a way I can mess with this. And maybe that was the point, just to do it for the sake of doing it. That was the only bit that I felt didn't really land very well. It just didn't feel like it really had a point behind it. Someone who's like tackled those topics really well and like cracked me up is Ricky Gervais, my probably all-time favorite comedian. But like when he talks about those topics, he comes with a proper humanistic point behind it as well, whatever it is he's saying. And I think that's what makes going into those topics that can be more touchy really good in comedy, is if you can bring some truth with it and some food for thought. And I just felt like Dave didn't really do that with that particular section. So it was good. It wasn't like incredible or anything. And those are just sort of my thoughts on that.